So good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon. I don't know why I said that three times, but just felt like I needed to say that. Okay, so it's a hot and humid Saturday afternoon. I'm just back from having been out in the city. Just hanging out for a little bit in the late hours of the morning. And then I went and had some beer, had some food, had some lovely prawns, and decided to come back home. It's around 3:30 right now in the afternoon, and probably take a nap or watch something, watch some of my TV series. And lo and behold, as when I came here, one of the packages has arrived, and very surprising, because it's actually, today's the 16th. I was expecting this package on either the 18th or the 19th. 18th is the Monday. So that's a couple of days in advance, and that's really pretty cool. This is from the US once again, from Missouri. And this particular seller does a fantastic job of, communication wise, as well as, sending it on time. He sends it on the exact same day. So another Star Trek Starship. This isn't a Starship per se, but give you a hint. Well, there you can see the Star Trek name and logo. One of the packaging things has flown off. Where is it? I'm going to have to get that later. Anyway, so it's from Star Trek Deep Space Nine. So that's the hint. Can you guess what it is? You've already seen the title, so you would know what it is. Okay, let's keep that aside for the moment and get the magazine. Oops. So I really hate this packaging because it flies off, from the force of the ceiling fan. Let's get that magazine out. I'm going to try to do that without upsetting too much of the packaging stuff, the thermocol little doohickeys, or whatever you want to call it. I call them peanuts. I don't know why, but I just do. Oh, they are flying off. Okay, so you saw that. Let's put away the box, get out of my bed. And yes, it is the Runabout from Star Trek. Okay, so it's the, I'm not sure if you pronounce it Danube or Danube. I don't know. Launched in the 24th century, length is 23.1 meters, a max speed of warp 5. It's a shuttle and it's a runabout. It's bigger than the normal shuttles that you have seen on some of, say, for example, on Star Trek TNG. But this is, I really like this design. I really like this shuttle. It's an awesome design. So here's a quick look at the magazine. That's a nice, lovely shot. Another shot with Terek Noor, Deep Space Nine in the background. I believe they can fit in a maximum of, let's see if we have that. What, 5-4 phaser arrays, one micro torpedo launcher, 23.1 meters, but it doesn't say how many people. If I'm not mistaken, you can fit probably like 6 people in it. In an emergency, maybe a little bit more. There are sleeping quarters as well. Let's have a quick look. I love the Delta Flyer, but while rewatching Deep Space Nine again, I think I really prefer this particular design. It's just really, really an awesome shuttle. And if it was slightly bigger, that would be a really fantastic ship as well, spaceship as well. So here's designing the runabout, how the older shuttles were, and then evolution into what we know and love as the Runabout series. This is the Orinoco, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, USS Orinoco. Here's another shot. Here's more from the television series. This is the Runabout studio model. And this, the current model that we are unboxing right now, is based on the original studio model and not the one that you see on the television series. There's the Hideki class, that's next. Probably might not get this ship, but it doesn't look that great. to me, and I'm not really a big fan of the design, so I am cherry picking. So, and last but not least, another shot from the top, and here's our box, here's the model. Let's quickly do and take the ship out. There she is. Pretty cool indeed. Here's the cockpit. Here's the warp nacelles. I think that's the torpedo launcher. Here's the back of it. It's pretty nice, pretty cool actually. Yeah, there's a. Oh, oops. Nothing happened. Here's a look at the ship along with the, can't believe I just dropped it, but nothing's wrong with, happened with it, so that's feels pretty solid. Oop, I almost dropped it again. Yeah. Word to the wise, don't do these unboxings if you are a little bit drunk. So, yeah, so that's the ship. We'll do another little video once I get her on the stand. I don't want to do that right now. I want to lie back and watch something, take a little nap perhaps. So I'll take that, shoot that a little bit later. So there she is, the runabout from Star Trek, mainly focused in Deep Space Nine. So take care guys, see you on the next video. Bye.